Well, it's Sunday, and not wanting to sit around the hotel room on such a nice day, I decided to get out, and I found out that there's an antique radio museum here in Connecticut, so I figured it might be an interesting place to go. But it's very easy to miss. You're going down the road here, and there's this little sign, and that's where it is. So let's take a look and see what we got at the Antique Radio Museum. We're here.
That's the energy coming off of what?
This museum encompasses quite a time period. All the way up from the 1800s through the modern era. They've got several very, very good collector pieces to see that you're not likely to see in very many places. Everything ranging from the high-end units all the way down to the ones available for the more common person. We've also got some old movie equipment, which is kind of fascinating. This is a portable unit that could be taken around from town to town to show movies on the backs of walls and so forth. And this particular one is very interesting in that it could actually be used today if they wanted to. And it can record the, it can play back the sound off of the strip in the film strip, but additionally there was another movie system at the time, and this could do that too, where the soundtrack would actually be on a big record and it would be synchronized. So I found that pretty neat. Now that's not something you won't see very often. This is the old dialing circuit from a telephone system. This was the mechanical dialer that was used when you placed your call, and it did that tit-tit-tit-tit-tit-tit-tit-tit, and it would go through the different things and connect the lines accordingly.
So this can only recognize 90 different numbers. If I add another number... And it would make contact with one of those.